This is my first experiment in my modular synthesizer project. It's a voltage-controlled oscillator by Music from Outer Space. It's designed by Ray Wilson, and it's based loosely on the old vintage Moog oscillators. And let's try it out. Here's the sine wave output. It sounds fantastic in the lower frequencies, very similar to an old mini Moog. We can also try the triangle wave output, which has some more harmonic information. This one gives an especially nice sound, especially at lower frequencies. There's also a ramp wave output, and this is actually a ramp core oscillator, so this is the core oscillation signal. Everything else is built on top of this via wave shaping circuitry. Additionally, there's a pulse wave or square wave output that has adjustable pulse width modulation. I did make a couple mistakes when initially putting this together. One mistake that I made was that, despite reading the instructions several times over, I forgot to put this little temperature compensation resistor in between the two matched NPN transistor pairs. Now, it still works because the TEMPCO resistor is in the same, it's connected electrically to the same spot that it would be if I put it in the right place, but it doesn't get the proper temperature compensation when the board heats up. But for my purposes, as just an experimenter, it works fine. Another mistake that I made is I put one of these transistors in backwards. Another mistake I made when sourcing components was I accidentally ordered some of these gigantic 2 kilovolt rated 0.1 microfarad capacitors. And they probably would have worked. They have the right capacitance value if I could even fit them on this board somehow. But the lesson I learned there was to pay attention when you're ordering a huge list of components. Using my cheap multimeter in frequency counter mode, I can actually check the range of this oscillator, and it gets down to about 1.8 hertz. And if I go through the full frequency range, I can get it up to 13 kilohertz, and that seems actually a little bit kind of low. It should be able to get up into the low 20s. About 20 kilohertz is the maximum frequency that humans can hear, so I'm not sure if that's due to another mistake that I made, or maybe the result of some of the cheap components I required. These potentiometers have pretty low tolerance, for example, so I'll have to investigate that further and see if I can find out what the cause is. Now, of course, this is a voltage-controlled oscillator, but I don't have anything like an LFO or a sequencer yet to modulate the frequency of the oscillator. But you can get a sense for how it works by connecting something to one of the control voltage inputs and just using the background radiation of the universe to get some interesting frequency modulation effects. So overall, I'm really pleased with how this project turned out. It wasn't that difficult to put together. If you can follow directions and you know how to solder, you can assemble this board pretty simply. And it's probably the most complicated circuit that you'll find in a modular synthesizer project. So I've already ordered a couple more of these boards, in addition to some higher quality components, in order to build the heart of my synthesizer project, which will be a dual VCO module with a custom front panel that I designed. In addition, I still have to build some LFOs, VCFs, VCAs, and a sequencer, which will be my own custom design. So stay tuned, more videos to come.